We are going to discuss the short story Fragments from a Life by Sharifa Al-Shamlan. Sharifa Al-Shamlan is a journalist and a short story writer from Saudi Arabia. And this particular story, Fragments from a Life, it portrays the life of a young deranged girl, a girl who has some mental problems, mental difficulties, who is a victim of patriarchal oppression and socialization. So, however, her mental illness empowers her to express herself without any limitations, like she can do anything without fear of anything. Despite it's written in a very simple language, the story is very dense and well crafted. So these are Fragments of Life from a Life. It is given in fragments actually. So the first fragments have it shows her age, that she is 20 and her mother died when she was 10, and she was brought here in this particular, probably it's a hospital, at the age of 70. And she can figure out, she used to, every birthday she used to plant a date palm tree. And then she says she can remember how many times her father visited, because during Ramadan he used to visit. Another fragment. So each fragment is given different names. Today is Waqfa, tomorrow is great festival. They are decorating place not because of the festival, but because the director is coming for a visit to the hospital. So she requested a pen and a paper, and she wrote long letter to her mother, and she also made a greeting card for their father, but they refused her request because they are afraid she is writing some complaint to the director. Because she doesn't even know to write, so she felt it very funny. And another fragment, this is another name of another fragment, where the director comes and she asks him whether she can touch the clock, and he asks, clock means his long dress, and he asks, why do you want to touch that? Because she says, I want to know how much it would cost so that I can sell it and I can get some money to buy candies for the children in my village. And the director just laughed and he went away. The next is a rare fragment, the sight of the chief doctor who makes her laugh, because he has got maps of fingernails, like how she used to scratch him, and all the marks are just like maps. A small fragment. So an orderly person brought her food and she asked no questions, and that person said, I gave the piece of meat to the neighbor's dog, he was hungry, and she just said, I hope he deserved it. Like even what she deserved, what is in her menu also is being taken away and given to some dogs and all. Next is a horizontal fragment. A nurse comes and then she asks the nurse, can you bring lot of palm prickles for me? When she asks what is it, then she says she wants to make a fence around her bed. Okay, and then she pinched that nurse's belly and then she went off in rush. She got scared. Next is a painful fragment. When her father says that he has sold that garden which contained all the date palm trees which she had planted. Last fragment is one elderly person comes to her and asks her, your name is there in the newspaper, and she says why, because the director asked, she had given her wish that she wanted all the children of her village to get candies. The director gave candies to all the children in her village, and then she became a part of the news, it is because of her, etc. And she just only asked one thing, were the children happy? And then the elderly person said that yes, they were, and then they telegrammed the director, thanking the director. So that is how the story ends. What we understand from this story is the fragments from a person who is deranged or person who has a mental difficulties, how their thought process works and what all things come to their mind, all absurd things which may not have connection between one to another. So that is why all these are given, that different fragments, what things are coming to her and how she is reacting to it is what we should deal with. So I hope you understood this portion. Thank you.